I need your body in ways that you don't understand, but I'm losing my patience, 'cause we've been going over and over again. Girl, I just wanna take you home and give out. Your body in ways that you don't understand, but I'm losing my patience, 'cause we've been going over and over again. Girl, I just wanna take you home and give out.
About to put this in, y'all. Megan Mew from Walmart. It's probably spicy. I don't even do spice, but we gonna see today. And I'm going to be doing my hair. So I got these. I'm going to put passion twists in there. So I'm going to do all of that in one video. So you guys just stay tuned. Hey y'all, it's me Snook Red, and welcome back to my channel. So today I am eating Mega Meal. It's really, really good. I think it's really, really good. I'm going to be trying it for the first time. And today we're going to be having story time and doing my hair at the same time. So today's video is about telling you guys a story about when I got abused from my ex-girlfriend. Not the recent one, but the one before that. So this is just a little story time, you guys, because I was just sitting down thinking, and I'm just like, okay, what can I speak about today? I think I'm going to speak about that. So you guys just stay tuned, because it's about to go down, Virgo gang. Let's try it. It tastes pretty good. It doesn't have like, you know, like some things just be, don't be tasting what it looks like. This actually tastes what it looks like. I just doing some little, you know, sausage in there. It's really good. Yeah, so it's really good, y'all. I like it. So refreshing. Oh, and I'm parting my hair, so you see a little. You guys don't even act like, yeah, I've never started my videos off with my hair looking a mess. Always, always, always. The only thing I don't like about it is that it's spicy, like. It's really spicy. But it's good, y'all. It's good. So, it all started. I met this girl like maybe 2 years ago. I don't know. I don't remember. But, sorry. I'm smacking. Hold on a second. Okay, so, it all started when I was, you know, me and her would talk on the phone. She's from Georgia and I'm from here. So at first we started off just doing like a long distance relationship. It started off like that. We both ended up liking each other, and we both were in the middle of trying to move out where we were at. So that's what happened. So that's what happened. She came to, so we waited for like a month before we made any decisions. I was in the process of moving out of my apartment, and she was in the process of probably like getting kicked out or whatever she had going on. So let me see what happened. So I thought I was going to still be living in my apartment at the time. So I did tell her that she can just come stay with me and we just pay the bills, whatever. But it took her a minute to get her stuff situated. And it also took me a minute to realize that I was getting evicted. Straight up. So, yeah. Anyways. So, she came. This is so good. So, I invited her to come. I invited her to come stay with me. She was at her friend's house, right? So, whatever they had going on over there, she ended up kicking her out. So I'm just like, I don't have any money for you to come right now. But I did end up moving out of my apartment, and I did have like a place that I found, and I only had to wait like a week or whatever. But I said, I don't have any money right now. I won't be able to come get you till like February the 28th. That's when she came. So she was going crazy. And then I was going to ask the lady that was renting me the room to see if she can help me, because they were like church people with a godly people. So I'm like, I'm going to see if they can help me get her on a Greyhound, and I just paid them back. That didn't happen. She ended up, she ended up staying with some co-worker of hers that she was staying with, whatever. And then when the 28th got here, I told her, when the 28th get here, you could just come stay with me in this rooming house. It was a shared rooming house. Rooming house, you had to share room with somebody. So thankfully, I talked to them about that and told them that she was going to be coming so I can share a room with her. And they really don't do couples, but I kept telling them that that was my friend. You know what I'm saying? I was telling them that was my friend, but they knew that was my girlfriend. I told them that too. So she ended up coming. The 28th came, she came, whenever she moved in. The first week was okay. The first week was a little bit rocky because of the simple fact that, I don't know, it seemed like everything happened too fast, you know. We both were trying to provide for each other. I didn't have a job at the time. She just, you know, left her hometown and just got kicked out. So reverse was okay. I would say like the second or the third week. So like the second or the third week, that's when things started getting really, really rocky. So when I do my passion twist, I always put a rubber bands in it first, so I can easily just wrap the hair around and go to twisting. So yeah, that's what I do, y'all. I be struggling sometimes. So the third week came. The third week came, and that's when things started getting rocky. What happened? You know, with her getting kicked out and stuff. So at first, see, we were staying with like old people that didn't like loud noises and stuff. So one of the ladies would say, hey man, she playing the music too loud. It was a Spanish lady. Our room was really close to hers, and but she was kind of annoying. So yeah, our room was really close to hers, and she just didn't give a fuck. Like, I would tell her, like, we can't be too loud, because we're living with older people, and we're supposed to just be trying to stay there for at least a month and get the fuck out of there. Because yeah, we couldn't do nothing. Like, it was so, it sucked. So I guess after the music incident, she probably started thinking about it like, damn, I don't even want to stay here. And I felt the same way. I didn't want to stay there. But long story short, when things started getting like that with the music being too loud, I guess she started feeling like she couldn't enjoy herself. Then she just realized that she had such a fucked up life. And with her coming to me, to where I'm at, you know, it wasn't the most happiest moment ever. You know what I'm saying? That's what I do, guys. I twist it. I twist it when it gets to the end of my hair. I twist it, and then that's when I braid it first till it gets to the end of my hair, and then I twist the rest. Yeah, so things pretty much wasn't working well. So our life, her life, but eventually I ended up getting a job. She was still currently trying to find a job. But you know, I would be the one to provide and provide for her, which she used to be an alcoholic. She used to love beer. She used to love her some beer. So I used to help her provide. I'm not gonna lie, I used to help her with the beer and stuff. She didn't have any money at all. But when she got her first check, she did help me out with some things, like, you know, the things that I like. So yeah, then come to find out, I started drinking, you know, almost every day as well. So every little money I get, I would split it on her getting her stuff, me getting my beer, and then everything just, we'll be chilling sometimes. Yeah, we'll be chilling. We'll have some few days, but we was really, really stressed out over there. Like, everything sucked over there. Like, it was hot. They didn't like the air too hot. If it get too cold, somebody was gonna turn it down. So, I mean, she wasn't living the, I feel bad because I feel like I sold her this dream that we were going to be in an apartment and we was going to be good. And I really did thought that. It was going to take us some time because I had to get her here first. I was trying to find something as quick as I can. And then she got kicked out way before we even got to plan anything. So everything, she was already booked to come on February. But things started getting really bad once I started working. So I'm gonna tell y'all how that goes. So when I started working, for somehow she wasn't working, but she was in the process of work of getting hired with Family Dollar, whatever. I was working at Panera Bread. It was the convention center downtown first. It was the downtown convention center. But anyways, I'm trying to make this story short because ain't nobody gonna wanna sit here and listen to me. Blah, 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 blah. So a little few weeks later, like later down the line, we sleeping or whatever. I'm laying in bed and I'm like, she's waking up with like scratches and sores and stuff or whatever, sores you might as well say. I'm going to sleep, you know, all itchy and stuff. Come to find out, the motherfuckers had fucking bed bugs. I was about to sue them and everything. I literally called the people and told them that them motherfucking people had bed bugs. So that was incident number one. So I'm gonna tell y'all what she did when we realized that. When we first realized that, I didn't know. I had no idea. I mean, before she came, I literally didn't know. If I would have known anything, I didn't know anything what they were. I didn't know nothing about them. All I know is I did see one bug crawling around. And then next thing you know, I started seeing more. But I thought they were just like dust mites or something like that, which that's bad too. But I'm just saying, like, so one time I got up in the morning getting ready to go to work. And she wakes up and she has like sores or whatever, bites all on her. And I guess she gets infected by it easier than I did. So she woke up one morning and I'm just like, I had no idea. So we would struggle with the bed bugs for like forever. You might as well say every single day, every day that we woke up, we had to struggle with it. We couldn't get rid of the bed. You know why? Because we didn't have any money to afford a bed. So the woman that actually rented us the room, the house and stuff, the room, and she was nice enough to buy us a blow up mattress. So it felt comfortable. We was only comfortable for like maybe two, for like a week and a half. Next thing you know, the freaking blow up mattress ended up getting a hole in it. So like I said, one morning I woke up and I said something about, I don't feel like going to work today because we will be up all night scratching, itching, scratching. It was nothing we can do. We had no choice but to sleep on it. We was trying to get new sheets. I bought new sheets and everything the best way that I could. Trying to get new covers, nothing worked. It was the whole entire bed just had to go. So I woke up one morning and all I said was, I think I don't feel like going to work because we were be up all, literally be up to like 5 o'clock or 6 o'clock in the morning because we were itching, we were scratching. So when I said, oh, I don't feel like going to work, I'm so tired, she slapped the shit out of me. Let me tell y'all, she said, boom, slapped the shit out of me. And I looked at her I did not know what to say. Like, I thought we were like this, like, I'm like, what did I say so wrong? Come to find out, she was really upset because she felt like I brought her away out here to deal with bed bugs. And, or either that, or I just, because I didn't want to go to work to make money. I didn't know which one it was, but that shit was crazy. She slapped the shit out of me. I don't remember what happened, what I said. All I know is that's all I remember. So I didn't react to it. I did react to it. I was upset. And she felt a little bit bad, but she really didn't. I just couldn't believe what just happened. That was so freaking crazy. So I did go to work, but I didn't notice any swelling or anything like that. I didn't feel any pain, but I'm still sitting there like, why would she do this to me? Why was she just slap me like that. I understand that I'm the one paid for you to come down here and stuff. And I really did not. I think it was because the bed bugs. I think it's because she was getting bitten up and she just got tired of everything. And so her first reaction was to slap me, though. Like, your first reaction was to slap me. Like, you could have just, like, I was trying everything I can to fix the situation with them fucking bed bugs. They are the worst to get rid of. Your best bet is to get the fuck out of that house and never come back. That's your best bet. So a couple of more weeks went by, and it's been almost a month or two. And like I said, the woman finally got us a blow-up mattress. But come to find out, the fucking blow-up mattress ended up getting a hole in it. And I'm like, what the fuck? We only had this blow-up mattress. It was a nice big queen size one too. It's really nice. But what the fuck? Like, we just got this blow-up mattress. We've already going through enough, Lord. Like, please, we're already going through enough. And now we were up all night again because the bed kept going down and we had to keep blowing it up in the middle of the night. Why? Because we did not have no fucking money. Things were horrible. So I don't really blame her for being stressed out. I just don't like the fact that why would you hit me out of nowhere? Like, it's not really too much of my fault. You got kicked out of your people house because of whatever you used to do. You know what I'm saying? So you come to my house, at least you're treated a little bit better, you know? So a month came by. I ended up finding another job. She ended up working at Family Dollar. I was working at Panera Bread, whatever. That's not the case. So I don't know, it was another incident that happened, you guys. This is another thing that she did to me that was horrible. I can't really remember because I would be so much lost of words. Well, it was another morning. I got up, I said some stuff, whatever. I don't know if we argued or if we didn't argue, but I said something. What did I say? I do not remember, y'all, but I said something and then boom, she slapped me in the same area. I was sitting in the same spot, in the same area, and she punched the shit out of me. So I did it again. I didn't react. I looked at her. I'm like, what the fuck is going on? Same thing with me when I meet somebody for the first time, I try to observe them first. Like, you can say whatever on the phone, but once you're around them and you're in their face, you gotta like really like think about some shit. Like, you gotta really observe. So that was me observing again. I'm like, what the fuck is going on? I didn't even notice that she drunk like that all the time. I didn't even know that when she wake up in the morning, she's drinking. So a lot of it had to do with her drinking and I believe the bed bugs and that we didn't have any money. And she just felt like, I can't believe I did this. And I like come from Georgia to Tampa. She could not believe that. And it's like, I couldn't believe that everything isn't going nowhere near. So I think that's why I would let her hit me. It's because I kind of knew where she was coming from. But you know, I don't give you the right to just swing on me. It's not literally my fault. It's actually both of our fault. So you should have slapped your goddamn self, but I let her get away with it the second time. So weeks and weeks come by.
In ways that you don't understand, but I'm losing my patience, cause we've been